Okay, let's take this opportunity to answer the allegations raised by Attorney Ferdowsi Abbas. Of course, he's the Vice Chairman of the MNLF for External Affairs. Yesterday, we were able to speak with him, and he said the decision was made. His decision was to break away from the Jikiri faction of the MNLF. Number one, he says that your group, the MILF, establishing a virtual dictatorship over the Bangsamoro because you control majority of the seats in the new Bangsamoro Parliament. Your response to that, sir?
Well, unang-una, Christian, everybody should understand na itong 3 years period is a transition mechanism. It is a transition period na hiningi ng MILF na bago magkaroon ng regular government, meron transition period to which ang objective natin dito is so transform the leadership, the MILF, especially the leadership, from revolutionary to governance and bureaucracy. So ito yung hiniling natin. Hindi, kung titingnan nyo yung nangyari sa MNLF, they have no transition period. Nagkaroon sila direct to the regular government. Pero ito, hinihingi natin ito sa negotiation and it was granted. Now, ang importante lang na provision dito, this will be led by the MILF. So, mas marami ang MILF in composition and in also in leadership and composition. So, kaya ang hatian nito sa government is the central government is 41, kasi 80 ang member, so 41 will be coming from our nominees, 39 will come from the nominees of the government, and yung kwan, MNLF, faction ni Yusuf Jikiri, is with the kwan, hindi kasama doon sa MILF slot. Doon sila sa slot ng GPH.
But even then, sir, they are complaining that supposedly they nominated 22 names for the to be part of the Bangsamoro Transition Authority. Of course, that would be allotted from the 39 seats by the government. But out of the 22 nominees, according to the MNLF, only 5 were actually appointed to the BTA. So the claim is that there's not enough representation as far as the MNLF is concerned in this transition government.
Well, that is already the discretion of the central government. Hindi namin sa klo yun, sa kanila na yun na discretion. Kasi itong 39 will be taken from the other sectors. So kasama dito yung mga sectors na non-MNLF. So yung mga iba-ibang sectors para lang mabalance itong plan. Because the transition period is for the MILF. We should understand. Kasi MNLF has already been in the government for several years. Hindi na kailangan nilang transition period because they are already in the government. Many of them have occupied positions in the government. Mm. So, hindi na itong transition lang is really kwan para sa MILF. So, there is no kwan. Now, it depends on the government now sa side nila kung sino yung mga sectors na ipapasok nila doon sa 39. So, yan ang nangyari na siguro nagkaroon lang kasi maraming mga sector gustong pumasok. So, the central government decided na yung mga recommendations, everybody have recommended, every sector nagkaroon ng recommendation. So, hindi nila kinuha lahat yung recommendation. They have to, balance yung appointment nila doon sa mga sectors.
And also, of course, the response to this next question might be too obvious because it was the MILF that negotiated for this peace agreement in 2014, which is now being implemented by virtue of the Bangsamoro organic law. But Attorney Abbas also claimed that the MILF could not claim credit over this law because there had been changes from the original BBL that was drafted by the BTC and the final outcome in Congress of the BOL. So, of course, the question that he raised was why the MILF had to secure the majority of the 80-member parliament of the Bangsamoro?
even the composition. If Tony Abbas remember, the composition of the gun, the BTC, majority pa rin ang MILF.
Yeah.
Yung gun, we are 50% one. Ngayon, sila sa MILF, ang slot nila doon din nang galing sa slot ng GRP. So, at that time, lima rin yata ang, if I remember it right, lima rin ang nakuha sa kanila. On our side is 11 ang nakuha sa ang amin. So, that means, kasi itong process ng legislation is a continuation of the process of the MILF-GRP peace process. Kasi after the agreement is forged, then the next step is to translate the agreement into law. Well, we can, kasi we acceded to the proposition of the president, the na maging inclusive ang bubuo ng law. So that is why we welcome the MNLF, we welcome the other sectors para masali sila doon. So,
now, Attorney Abbas,
yung pa rin ang kuan, yung pa rin ang basic na law is yung BBL na ginawa ng MILF.
Now, Attorney Abbas is also questioning directly your competence, sir. Pardon for this next question. He's basically questioning your competence to serve as the new chief minister of the Bangsamoro Transition Authority. He said, "I don't think Murad even has the vision to make this work." Your response to that, sir?
Ano yung comment niya? So, sorry,
he's questioning your competence. He said that you're not qualified to be the next chief minister, and according to Attorney Abbas, he doesn't think that you even have the vision to make this work.
Well, wala namang provision ng law specifically na nagkukuha na ang magiging puno ng gobyerno lang ay yung maybe abogado o ano ang guan, credential, because there is no such law. Kasi kung merong such law, then that is violative of my own. Then hindi ako i-appoint ni Presidente. I was appointed by the President because I am the head of the MILF. I am the chairman of the MILF, and the transition period is supposed laid by the MILF. So natural na I will be appointed as the chairman of the transition, the chief minister, as head of the government, because I am the head of the MILF.
But in terms of qualification or the ability to actually run the transition government, what's your response to those who are questioning these very qualifications that you supposedly lack?
Well, it is true. I have never been in government for more than 50 years. I have been running the organization for more than the revolutionary organization. And you will notice that there has been no challenge in my leadership in the organization. So while I have no experience in governance, that is why we are hilingi namin itong transitional period para there will be a chance for us to transform from the revolutionary into a governance bureaucracy.
Now, Chairman Murad, why do you think Attorney Firdausi Abbas is raising these issues now? The fact that you already took your oath last Friday and formally or officially the Bangsamoro Transition Authority has been established, the Bangsamoro government, the new autonomous region has been set. Why do you think he's raising these issues now?
Well, I'm not sure what is his real reason or motive. But ang na-notice natin is among the former nominees of the government in the BTC, parang siya lang ang hindi na-appoint uli dito sa DTA. All the others, BTC members appointed by the government, nominated by the government, were also appointed in the BTC. So we do not know what is the reason why he was not included.
Do you think he's only bitter because he was not nominated by his own MNLF faction to the BTA?
Well, that remains to be kan. Siya ang makasasagot nito because I do not want to preempt his kan.
Now, let's go to the implications of this decision by Attorney Ferdowsi Abbas to bolt his MNLF faction. Of course, for the benefit of our viewers here, there are three factions so far of the MNLF, one by Nur Miswari, by Muslim Insema, and Yusuf Jikiri. So Attorney Abbas belongs to the faction of Yusuf Jikiri here. Now, he says he's going to form another faction. So in case that happens, that will be the fourth MNLF faction here. What are the implications here, considering that you're trying to organize things at this stage, at this point in the Bangsamoro?
Well, we have talked to during this taking itself. Nandun si Brother Yusuf Jikiri and his group. Nandun ang kwan. In fact, he recommended one of their group to be one of the to be appointed to be to the post of deputy chief of minister for the island provinces. So siya mismo ang nag-recommend nito. Yung isang brother namin na kasama rin nila sa grupo. So he is well on board dito sa kwan. And sa panig ni Muslim Insema, iisa lang ang grupo na yan, hindi dalawa. Iisa lang sila.
Yeah.
Although, Muslim Insema is the chairman of the Bangsamoro National Congress, which is also the kwan, the legislative body of the MNLF na under Yusuf Jikiri. So isa lang ito sila. So they are on board na nandoon sila during the oath taking, and yung representation nila ay pinagkasunduan nila, and they are quite sad also that not all their recommendations were taken, but ang tingin ko they also understand the situation of the president. Kailangan kumuha rin sa ibang mga sektor.
Mm-hmm. Now, how influential actually is Attorney Abbas? And in case he makes good on his promise to bolt the MNLF, how big a following can he command?
Alam mo, Attorney Abbas, if I remember right, hindi naman siya MNLF. Very recently lang nag-join siya sa MNLF. Because ang original na organization nila is yung BMLO, Bangsamoro Liberation Organization. Kasama yung kapatid niya na si Juan, who already passed away.
Yeah.
So, I do not see how strong ang following ni Attorney Ferdowsi in the ground. Kasi wala tayong nakikita prominent na area where he is in command of any group. Hindi natin alam kung gaano ka-influential as far as the MNLF is concerned.
And of course, he also clarified during the interview yesterday that this particular faction that he wants to put up would pursue the aspirations of the Bangsamoro along pacifist lines. So he made it clear that there's no taking up of arms here, meaning another armed struggle, given the fact, of course, that the MNLF already signed its final peace agreement with the government in 1996. Now, the next question, sir, is how do you manage discord like this, given the fact that you're now going to run the new Bangsamoro government?
Well, sa panig namin, we are always inclusive. We welcome everybody to join us in the government, in the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region in Muslim Mindanao. During the transition, it will be led by MILF, but there will be an election in 2022, so everybody is welcome to participate. And wala nang kwan, there is no more provision that we will be at the leading seat in the regular government. It depends on how the people will judge. It depends on how many parliament seat of parliament na makuha namin through our political party and through the individual candidates that will run in the district. So everybody is welcome to join, because now we accepted that from revolutionary struggle, we will now join the democratic process, democratic struggle. So we will accept whatever the verdict of the people comes 2022.